that most of people's time in terms of learning happens out of school, not at the formal environment.
ISE is a huge bucket. It's everything from a one-off visit to a museum to a super intensive, immersive, it's an after-school program, it's a summer program where it's 24/7 and you're just piling the learning on to a very, very long-term interaction with citizen science.
The thing that I would like researchers to know is that they don't have to do broader impacts by themselves. They're not in isolation. There are professionals who are ready and willing to meet with them at any time to help them come up with unique and innovative ideas that match what they like.
One of the things that's made informal science education grow, expand, and be more credible over the last decades has been its attention to an evidentiary base of knowledge.
We could stand up our results against what others were finding.
My programs have been pretty individualistic. You know, I get an idea and I think, oh, I could go give talks in churches. Oh, I could go start a prison program. But I think what I've learned, and now that I've been more involved with CAISE, is what a tremendous resource that is, especially for people like me who are trained as scientists and not as science communicators or informal science educators.
We have great chemists. They have great training in chemistry. They have almost no training in informal science education and communication, but they're very smart people and they like to use best practices. What I'm going to work to do as I go forward is get people that are chemists to take these best practices from informal science education and communication and implement them.
Science communication is so important because it's a way for scientists to share something that they love. Scientists got into science because they love it, but they also want to make the world a better place. And communicating about what they're doing lets them achieve that.
Well, as a scientist, I feel that we have an ultimate responsibility to the global citizenry to share what we learn as soon as possible and as effectively as possible. Without the engagement of the scientific community, we're not going to be able to solve those problems.
CAISE has in its repository 10,000 or so resources that speak to the actual evidence and data for the impact of this strategy in science education.
Scientists have passion and they have knowledge and content of what they study. And those two things allow them to be very powerful communicators. So to be able to go to the website, I see it as a shortcut to this world of informal science education that allows someone like me as a scientist to carry out more meaningful, more significant informal science education.